Our research provides hope that we have a near-term medicine to treat Alzheimer's disease. My name is Jerold Chun. I'm a professor and senior vice president for neuroscience drug discovery here at Sanford Burnham Prebys Medical Discovery Institute. Alzheimer's disease is the most common cause of dementia in the US, affecting some 5.7 million people, and that number is going to be going up very rapidly in the coming decades. Alzheimer's disease is devastating to the individual. It falls into two basic categories: those that are inherited and those that are not. The inherited forms account for perhaps just 1%. That raises the question of what's going on in that other 99% of cases. What one has been taught in school for many, many years is that every single cell in your body has an identical blueprint, identical genome that started from that initial fertilization step. What we found is that they change the very blueprint of a given cell. That is one of the core implications of the study that we've just reported. Scientists have referred to this as gene recombination. Gene recombination is a natural process, and in fact, it is the basis of our immune system. Gene recombination is a process where a stretch of DNA is cut, and then another piece can be brought to that cut piece to form a new DNA sequence. This is very similar to bringing together pieces of film. You can splice it together, and that would form your new movie or your new edited movie. The key finding from this work is that gene recombination occurs within the brain. It involves this gene referred to as APP, or amyloid precursor protein, that then can form the amyloid plaques, thought to be a major cause of Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's is a disease where recombination goes awry. Identifying gene recombination also led to an understanding of some of the very basic mechanisms that produce the recombination. There's an enzyme that we identified that is well known to many, many, many biologists, called reverse transcriptase. And this enzyme is quite famous because it was the first to overturn the so-called central dogma. Going from DNA to RNA to protein, the reverse transcriptase will take an RNA and turn it into a DNA, so it goes backwards. And why is that interesting? Well, it suggests that you might be able to interrupt that enzyme's activity and then actually bring about some therapeutic advantages. HIV is treated in part by inhibitors of this reverse transcriptase. We then proceeded to look through the literature at individuals that were in that 65-ish range or older, of which there are approximately 100,000 taking these reverse transcriptase therapies for many, many years. We would have predicted there should have been 2,000-3,000 people with Alzheimer's disease in that age group. And what we found in the literature was at this point there had only been one report of Alzheimer's disease in that HIV population. The exciting possibility is that we could take already FDA-approved agents that have been in humans in some cases for decades and test them in actual Alzheimer's disease patients. It would be remarkable if it turns out that HIV, this terrible disease, gives rise to the first effective treatments for Alzheimer's disease.